This video will teach you the basic elements that are used in game design. A good game sets an objective for the player, obliging the player to do something. This goal gives purpose and meaning to the player's experience, and therefore makes it valuable to invest hours and hours on this virtual playground. The player has to undertake certain actions to achieve the objective. In most cases, the objective is divided into challenges. The player needs to undertake actions to fulfill these challenges and make progress throughout the game. The challenges will gradually grow and become harder to achieve. On the other hand, the player will be given more and more abilities to reach these goals. These variables can be walking, jumping, ducking, or punching. By playing the game, the player will experience which actions have positive consequences and which actions have negative consequences. By rewarding and punishing the player with a consequent feedback system, the player will learn how to balance the given abilities and make the right choices within the game context. The score model, playground, and variables are defined by a set of rules. These rules determine the size and elements of the playing field. Using the given elements in the most optimal way will give the player the sense of mastery. The user interface should be designed intuitively and should be based on common laws of interaction design. Design should be consequent and show feedback of each action the player undertakes. The final part of the game design is to define a central theme or metaphor of the world where play takes place. This will define the matching visual style. Although described as being the last part of game design, it is actually the first element that determines if a player will start playing or leave the game as it is. Pink ponies, for instance, will never be my cup of tea. If the visual style is appealing to the player, he or she will want to know what the goal of the game is. If a player does not understand what to do, and if it's not fun, he will stop playing. After understanding what to do, he will start playing and start experimenting. The beauty of games is that players love to experiment in the game, even if it means risking their lives. Even if they have only 3 in most games. The player will experience which actions have a positive or negative effect by the designed feedback system and score model, eventually teaching the players to become the master of the game. Players that master the game will start to compete with their previous score or with other players, which is the social element of the playground. Although most people are more or less sensitive to a form of competition, other key drivers in games are the drive to learn, defend, acquire, or bond. These elements will be explained in a different presentation. We hope this video gave you a good insight in the basics of game design. Find more information about gamification, game design, and applied gaming at brandnewgame.nl. And feel free to download your personal copy of the book, A Brand New Playground.